inside a nasty trap and wait when he comes.
Hello everyone, here's a quick little tutorial on how to become Shock from Nightmare Before Christmas. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take some spirit gum and I'm going to put this all over my brow hair, making sure to coat every single hair. Then I'm going to take this spatula looking end of a brush and I'm just going to basically flatten out my brows against my skin. Once you've done that with both brows, then we're just going to wait until the brows become tacky. So while I'm waiting for the spirit gum to become tacky, I'm basically just going to outline the shape of Shock's face. She has a very narrow, upside down triangle looking face. So I'm just outlining what I want that to look like. I'm also drawing her neck and her collar, but I'm going to be adjusting this later on. Now that the spirit gum is tacky, I'm taking a whole bunch of translucent powder and I'm pushing that into my brow hair, and then I'm using just a brush to brush off the excess. I'm also just cleaning up an excess of spirit gum around my brow hair with a bit of paper towel and just warm water. Now I'm taking a black aqua color, this one is by Ben Nye, and I'm just filling in all of that negative space that we outlined earlier. Now to create her skin color, I'm using this Ben Nye color wheel and I'm mixing a bit of the green, yellow, black and a bit of white as well to create the skin color that I wanted. And I'm just going to start putting that all over my face. So I've also recently realized that I am allergic to glue stick glue. So the way I'm covering my brows right now is a way that I'm working on perfecting. So just bear with me. If you're not allergic to glue, just use glue sticks. It's much easier. But here I'm basically taking that cream color that I made and I am pushing that onto my brow. And then I'm going to be covering that with a whole crap ton of translucent powder, and then I'm going to dust off the translucent powder and repeat this step with cream, then powder a couple times until I think my brows are looking pretty smooth. So here I'm taking more of that cream color and I'm using that spatula looking end of that same eyeshadow brush, and I'm basically just filling in all the gaps between the hairs right now and being very precise with where I'm putting this cream color. And then you guessed it, I'm going to be following that up with a ton of translucent powder to set it. Okay, so at this point, I feel like my brows are going to look as smooth as they possibly can with this method. So I'm taking that cream color and I'm basically putting that all over my forehead. At this point, I switched to a flat eyeshadow brush to place that cream color more precisely in the areas that I want. Don't put any of this green on top of your eyelids because we are going to be putting something else in this area. At this point, I also started filling in my neck with that same green cream color as well. Now I'm setting everything with a bit of translucent powder at this point. So now I'm taking a Melt Reflect eyeliner in the shade Neptune, and I'm smudging that all over my eyelids. Now I'm taking my BH Take Me Back to Brazil palette, and I am mixing two of the dark blue colors and I'm setting that eyeliner with these colors. I'm placing these colors underneath my eye as well, and I'm repeating these steps for my other eye as well. So now there's still a bit of skin showing through around my eyes, so I'm taking some of that green cream color and I'm just putting that on the skin so it covers it. Now, just to make blending easier, I'm taking some translucent powder and I'm basically just setting all of that cream makeup around my eyes. So now I'm taking those two dark blue shadow colors and I'm basically blending out all the edges around the eyeliner. Chalk also has really deep eye bags under her eyes, so I'm taking that same blue shadow and I'm basically starting to create the shape of eye bags. Now I've also taken some black shadow and I'm putting that in the same area as the eye bags just to help deepen them and make them look puffier. Okay, so now we are going to contour the crap out of Shock's nose. Shock has a very long pointed nose. So basically I'm taking some green shadow from that same eyeshadow palette and I'm putting this all on the sides of my nose. And just keep layering on the green and blending it out towards the sides of your nose, making sure not to get any of this dark green shadow on the bridge of the nose. So just keep it on the sides and blend out. I'm also putting some of this dark green shadow underneath my nose and close to my nostrils as well. And to blend out the dark green, I'm just using a fluffy brush here. At this point, I'm taking a tiny bit of black eyeshadow, and I'm basically putting this on the sides of my nose just to further make those contour lines pop. So I also decided that I wanted to make her nose look longer, so I basically am bringing the contour lines that we made all the way up between my eyebrows. Okay, so now it's time to draw on her mouth. So I'm taking just a dark eyeliner and I'm basically outlining where I want her mouth to be. Now, Shock has these really pale blue lips, so I'm taking this lipstick by Lime Crime called Thistle and I'm using this to draw her lips in. Now, with another eyeliner, I'm just drawing out the shape of her teeth. Now I'm basically filling in the inside of her mouth with just black lipstick on top of a fine detail brush. And to fill in her teeth, I'm using Jeffree Star Druglord Liquid Lipstick and I'm just putting that where I would want the teeth to be. Here I decided that I wanted to make her lower lip a little bit lower on my chin, so I'm just adjusting the placement of that. Now I'm taking that same green base color and I'm just filling in all the empty spots. Now I'm just outlining her lips with a bit of black shadow. So now I'm basically going to start working on the chest. I apologize for that mirror being right in front of my chest. I move it in a bit, but I was just trying to figure out where to put the mirror so I can see what I was doing. So here I'm drawing on her collar, and I'm also drawing on her arms and dress on my chest as well, just because I want her to look like she has a huge head and a tiny body like she does in real life. And by real life, I mean in the cartoon. So now I'm also drawing her hands. So at this point, I figured out where to put the mirror so it doesn't show up on top of my chest, but I'm taking more of that black aqua color by Ben Nye and I'm just filling in all of that negative space on my shoulders and chest. Okay, so now I'm taking a Lime Crime liquid lipstick in the shade Cement. It's gray and I'm just filling in her collar and her gloves with this color. And now I'm filling in her dress with a Kryolan purple aqua color. So I'm using some eyeliner here to outline different parts of her dress and her gloves. With a dark brown eyeshadow, I also added in some shading on her dress too. And now I'm just adding this hat that I basically just took a bunch of purple felt and I hot glue gunned it onto a witch hat. And just tease my hair a bit, and here's the final look. So thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Definitely check out both Lena's and Jordy's YouTube accounts and Instagram accounts as well. They're absolutely amazing and so inspiring. And yeah, thank you so much for watching.